It is finally here, our Vikings Online user franchise, which should be a ton of fun. Of course, a big challenge as well. But of course, preseason, we have the Raiders, we have the Niners, and we have the Broncos. And then a tough home matchup against Aaron Rodgers and the Packers, of course. I don't know how many times I'm going to have to say this, because for some reason, people like can't look at the top right of the screen, or the fact that the circle on the bottom of all the players on our opponents literally lights up like blue or whatever the hell the color is. But this is a league of 32 users. So anyone, you know, this could be like episode 6, people are like, is this with other players? It's like, yes, and it's a full league, okay? I don't know how many times I have to say it, but please, just let me live. Of course, looking at the roster, this is a roster that we did about like a week or so, like 2 weeks ago. And you know, by the time this is uploaded, it'll probably be 2 weeks ago. So it's not going to be fully like updated. We still have Kellen Mond, which I love because, I mean, I get it in real life. He's not really shown a whole lot of promise, but I think he has a lot of promise in the game. As far as Kirk Cousins goes, sure, his ratings are solid, but no matter what I do, unless you can get QB breakouts for guys that are 34 years old, even if you could, I don't think I can save him. Like, I would literally have to have, I'd say, two breakout scenarios throughout the year and then an end of the season breakout to make him an X factor to save him. And that is very unlikely. It is super unlikely because I think Kirk Cousins' ratings are solid, but normal development trait. How am I supposed to save a 34-year-old normal development trait quarterback? In a Vikings rebuild we did recently, he dropped to like a 73, I think, after year one or something ridiculous. Maybe it was 77 and then a 71, which is just awful. But of course, the other offensive players in general are decent. So let's say we try Mond out. It doesn't work out. Kirk Cousins could lead us to a Super Bowl. I know it's crazy to think, but this is a very talented offense right out the gate. But the team definitely is worrisome down the line with Adam Thielen getting older and regressing hard early. Same with Harrison Smith. Zadarius isn't too far behind. Kendricks probably isn't too far behind. We have Sue because we did a free agency draft where you know, everyone got to pick a player before it's free reigns of free agency. Of course, nobody can grab Odell Beckham right now. I think we're gonna have him sign with a team that's like in the playoff hunt like later down the line. I don't think I'm going to be one of those teams unless like Thielen or Jefferson gets hurt. I don't think I'm going to be one of those teams in the fight for him because we just probably won't need him. Of course, you don't see Jalen Reagor here because, once again, this is a two-week-old roster. However, the Eagles user and Rod, we both made a trade, and we will have Reagor whenever the actual trade works because right now it's saying like send to the undefined. So hopefully next week it'll work. We ended up trading him a little bit more than real life. We did it before the trade actually came out. And once again, he is 93 speed. He is younger. He has, you know, a decent bit of potential. We gave a third this and a fourth next for Jalen Reagor and Tyree Jackson, which we're probably going to move him at quarterback to give him a chance too, because he has the most, like, I wouldn't say potential, but he has the highest throw power. He's very athletic, so we'll see, and if not, we could always just use him at tight end, because we kind of need the tight end depth anyways. So, I mean, a little over-trading, but, you know, at the same time, it's debatable that, like, you know, maybe the Vikings do worse than us in real life than we do in the game. But yeah, the offense looks great. Obviously, probably looking to replace the center down the line, the right guard maybe, but I like everyone else. They are lower overalls, but they are also younger. Ezra Cleveland, 24 years old. Darisaw, I can't imagine, is over 23. Which he is not. He's 23 on the nose. Right tackle's great, obviously. The right guard's got potential because he's young. Irv Smith still has potential. You know, looking at the defense like we were talking about. D-line, probably need to replace Sue. Not even probably. We will need to replace Sue. Maybe Dalvin Tomlinson. I like Asamoah. I'm not worried about him too much. Kendricks, I am, though. Corner 1 and 3 might need to be replaced. I put Dantzler on the trade block because I don't know, 87 speed, is he going to be able to get some speed upgrades? We'll see, but if he doesn't get speed upgrades early, he's going to be kind of unusable because he's going to get torched at 87 speed, but it's not a bad team. It's just really worried about, you know, future regressions with Kendrick Smith, Zadarius Smith, potentially Danielle Hunter even. I've seen him regress a lot, and I think it may even be like glitched in our league as well. I'm not sure, but maybe a little bit safer there. And obviously Adam Thielen and Kirk Cousins, so you know, it's a really good roster that I hope to at least make the playoffs, if not year one, year two. But we're getting way ahead of ourselves. Let's just get to preseason. And of course, but if you guys are excited for this series, maybe leave a like, as if we get to, I'll make it low just for the first episode, 500 likes, we will upload episode 2, aka week 1, tomorrow. And that's kind of special, because for this series, I can't just upload it whenever I want, you know? I can't just record 10 straight episodes like I could for Seahawks franchise, which I don't. I usually only record one episode ahead because I want to keep it about as relevant as possible. I don't want to, you know, record 10 episodes and then someone's like, oh, this guy's number changed. It's like, oh, my bad, dude. Or, you know, I know for Tariq Woolen for the Seahawks franchise. But yeah, 500 likes and we will do episode 2 tomorrow, aka once again, week 1 against the Green Bay Packers. But let's get back to this preseason. Next week, we will have Jalen Reagor and Tyree Jackson. This week, we didn't have them because the trading is literally bugged. I'll show you what I mean. Here we go, and send to the undefined. It's like, okay, that's, don't know what that means. But yeah, I'm not 100% sure what preseason games you're going to see. This is the first preseason game that I'm playing. Hell, this is the first preseason game I'm playing in the league history. I've never played preseason in the online league. And we're looking to try to play these because we're going to need to constantly move sliders around and overall see what the gameplay is like and, you know, people getting used to next gen. Because once again, I haven't really played a whole lot of next gen head-to-head games. This year will be by far the most I play. And yeah, let's go in and let's see how the team's looking. So pretty much, I don't know what the presentation's going to be like for online. I think it's pretty much just straightforward, like get the hell in the game and stop your complaining. We get the ball first, which is nice, which means we may get extra drives with our starters. I'm not going to be subbing players in or anything like that. If anything, I would be subbing them out because I don't want the starters playing too long. We do have injuries off just so we can test things without people, like, you know, freaking out. Not a great return from Nguyen Wu, by the way, with, you know, people freaking out. Like, why should I even play? I'll just pretend like I'm out of town and not have to waste, you know, players in preseason being injured in that. It's like, yeah, that kind of makes a lot of sense. Going to run a couple of base plays. I'm not going to do anything crazy. And that is a huge hit out the gate, 7 yards. That's going to be the really big challenging thing for me in this league, is not running too many short throws and short plays. 2nd and 3 now. Play action. And we're just going to take the shot, and he picks it off. I don't know if that was actually a bait, but it was a good play regardless. But we can't even get to him. Can we get to the, wow, he should have just ran, to be honest, to the 12 on a pick. And he takes a short throw. First play, touchdown to Renfro. Nice. And taking a shot to Thielen. Good D with the swap. 3rd and 10, looking for the first down. I don't even remember what the hell the routes are, to be honest. And that's a really good catch by Smith Marset, who once again, I think, is another guy that got released in real life, in fairness. And there goes an inaccurate ball. I might have taken too long to throw that. Look at this. Look at this. Jesus. And that's picked. 1st and 10 from the 42-yard line. Run call. Really good job by us with Asamoah. Yeah, I mean, I'm glad that we're playing preseason because I am going to need some time to get used to this. I will say, if we don't decide to remove the stadium abilities, it is going to be a long year for a lot of people. And that's a good pick by us with Harrison Smith. And not going to make a play. Oh, don't fumble. That's going to, I'm going to die in real life, dude. It's going to be some picks this year. At least we're out of the, like, dead zone, kind of, in a way. Underneath, they're going to call potentially PI on him there, to be honest. Nope, they're going to call holding on me. He declined it. What a guy. I really thought it was going to be PI on him. I couldn't really tell the depth at which he was, you know, at when he kind of pressed us. Oh, there you go, Dalvin. I'm still, you know, pretty sus with the juke ability and all that, but, you know, going to try to get better. And like I said, it's good that we're in preseason because this would be such a disaster if this was week one, dude. Yeah, it's pretty nice when you can actually see the field. And the screen works. That's all right. We'll take about 6. And I'm just going to take it. Okay. I was in trouble and I was like, screw it. Kirk on the move getting hammered. I forgot about the scrambling stuff. All right, Kirk Cousins, we need a drive here. Oh, that's a terrible throw by me, but under pressure as well. Comeback route from Jefferson could be the hot. Oh, that's good coverage by him. I did not expect his guy to actually just cover it. I just predetermined the hell out of that. Man coverage against, what's his name? Against Renfro, that's actually not a bad call. Good job. You know, that's Davante Adams' booth all over that. Pretty good coverage, to be honest. Just really, really tough. Just like it's really tough to commentate while playing. I forgot what it's like to play these online games. Lewis Seen, really good coverage, actually. Gain of 4, man. It's going to be tough this year, dude. And this is like, you know, this is early on. So, like, imagine what it's going to be like when teams actually have, like, legit high-rated corners and all that. Oh, that's a good find. Miss of Patrick Peterson. Oh, I couldn't get off there in time. We brought a lot of players. Oh, Harrison Smith with a second pick. We need this. We need a touchdown of that because we're not going to score anywhere else. I swear there's going to be quarterbacks with 100 picks on the season. And he missed. That might have been a me thing again. I am so bad with that. Like, I don't want to turn it off for this series because, like, it'll just make me look like a little weenie. But, man, I suck with it. Like, I'm so bad. There we go. Oh, we sold. No, we sold as well. White people don't have agility. Oh, we got the second string in now. This is interesting. Kellen Mond on the run. No fumble, thankfully. Gains about 9 on the play. Gotta love the game's idea of preseason. Mid-drive, screw that, dude. No, don't catch it. Madison and a wide receiver. We just don't have the depth, do we? It is kind of crazy, though. Like, he can come out with the wrong formation, bring the blitz, and because O-line sucks this year, it just doesn't matter that he had the wrong personnel, and it's just, it works out. Like, there we go. Don't fumble. That's the one thing I'm going to be strugglesome with this year. I'm looking at me accidentally setting up the Kellen Mond story arc. Oh, look at Kellen Mond doing pretty well. Maybe he should be the starting quarterback. I'm telling you, that's not the thing. That's a great catch by Jalen Naylor, who I really didn't give too much of an idea of as a starter, but, you know, nobody's really guaranteed a position anywhere on this field other than, you know, the obvious ones, like running back 1, wide receiver 1, all that. Up the middle, Ty Chandler, never having a chance. Jesus, loses 1? I mean, personally, I would have said lost more like 3, but, you know, same thing, I guess. To the end zone, Chandler, touchdown, finally got on the board. That's good D. There's a sack for Wanham and whoever the hell the other guy is. Robinson. John Johnson. What the hell's Johnson? And dropped. Bruh. It's already happening. How we drew it up, baby. Okay, dude. Sullivan playing safety. Man, this roster is kind of disastrous. Harrison ain't messing around. This is not good, but he's got it on the wrong side a little bit. Uh-oh, he took the wrong step. He's lucky. I don't know if he'd have got that dive, but I think Nwangwu had the step on him there for a sec. Jalen Naylor. Madison's playing like a primary role out here. And he's doing a good job of it. Oh, he's still going. Madison. 85-yard touchdown. Let's go. Going to be against the tight end with the safety, Bynum. Oh, I missed hard. Good tackle by Sullivan, but it's going to set him up on a third and, you know, short. Oh, that's a good throw and slightly overthrown. It's going to be a field goal attempt. Naylor on the return. Why not? Give him a chance. And why not? I'm not returning the ball this year. Ooh, the OP play from years past. Could it be? And there goes another running back. Chandler getting some yards and a face mask. I'm going to decline it, though. It doesn't really count. Chisena, the speedster. Throw it away. Ah. What was it? The damn tuck rule involved here. What the hell was that? He doesn't see the screen. Bruh. They're just going to run it with Nwangwu. Oh, we got some room. Nwangwu showing off the speed. Down the sideline for 73. What a play. Well, that's one way to score, I suppose. Man, we really started off really badly, and we've kind of turned it around. Once again, like I said, I'm going to need... Oh, crap. I forgot we didn't even have this because the practice thing... I suppose throwing at medium, even though Kirk Cousins, I don't imagine, is going to be the guy, and I'm going to defend medium. Harrison Smith still starting. Jordan Hicks trying to blow it up. I don't know if that was a screen or not a screen, a read option, but Zamir White, the backup running back, who could actually get some burn for him, is... This guy has got a lot of potential. A lot of potential for sure. And that's going to be a pick for Asamoah, who could score. Oh, he dove early. Stidham in pursuit. Can't catch him. Touchdown, Asamoah. Doing that dance makes me sad. That's a good play call. Good try by Sullivan. Going to back to the same well. Still blitzing, but not the same level. It's also not man coverage. And in trouble, you just can't run. Especially with a non-athletic quarterback, you just can't run this year. Like, it just never happens. Oh, that's a good play. Harrison Smith in pretty good coverage. Hicks is going to get the pick, though. Under pressure, underthrown. The guy that probably won't see the field a crazy amount gets an interception. Pitch to the left. Try to get our run game going a little bit. Actually, I'm going to play this normal. That linebacker probably isn't going to be able to take on Osborne. And that's a really good throw. What? That was a wreck. What is that? Mond may be the quarterback. I'm just going to be honest with you. Mond very well may be our quarterback. Slant, Naylor back in the end zone, maybe. Mond utilizing the legs. No fumble, thankfully, to the four. Mond on the run. Can't get away. Good try, though. That's a field goal. Good defense. And we can't get out there with Troy Dye. Mate, I do not know how to do the cut moves like he does. Like, I don't know, like, what that is. Like, I've not experienced this yet. But what I can tell you this is it's impossible to play defense, it seems. Like, again, you know, against that. Like, you literally are stuck in the sand. Oh, there we go. Sullivan. Pick six. Could be picked again. Bynum gets another. We're going to sit down as we're going to try to get out of this game without, you know, too much fatigue. And he's going to take another sack. That one I can see. You know, we didn't even turn left yet by the time the guy was all over us. Alrighty. Alright, so the game ends 41-10. Didn't really want to show too much in the fourth. It was, you know, a little bit of a slop fest, and obviously Kellen Mond came out swinging. Of course, Kirk Cousins, we really struggled out the gate with some interceptions, and we picked it up a little bit with him, but overall, obviously Kellen Mond was the much, much better quarterback. Tyree Jackson, going to be thrown into that bunch next week, assuming the trade actually works. Ty Chandler was not great. Either was Nwangwu, to be fair. You know, we had that huge run, and outside of that, I mean, really struggled on the ground as far as Dalvin and all that. Nothing really special. The ground game was really bad for us. Receivers, Naylor was all right. I really liked what I seen from Osborne, and it sucks because I know in real life he's actually probably the projected three, but he's 25, dude. A Madden franchise wide receiver that is literally the same like skill level as some of the other guys but is older, it just doesn't work out. Look at all the interceptions as well, which is brutal. Of course, for the scoreboard, I mean, he's still getting used to it as well, I'd imagine. But more importantly, he didn't have as many starters in, I don't think, as we did throughout the end of that one. All right, here we are playing at home against the Niners. Another really good roster in preseason. Definitely nice to, you know, test out the team against another good team. We have a new kicker, Garibay. He's got way better kick power. He's a rookie, and, you know, that's all I can really say. Those are the only things that matter. We did get our trade in for Tyree Jackson and Rager. Quarterback Jackson is the number three at the moment, and Mond is actually the number one, because as of right now, he kind of projects to be the starter. If Tyree Jackson plays well here, even if against the three, you know, the third stringers, he could be the starter 100%. Not sure what our quarterback spot's going to be like, so weird to say 100% when, you know, you know what I mean. But of course, Deebo Samuel, really good players here. Za'Darius dropping back, though. I'm actually just going to blitz at this point. It doesn't even matter. Harrison going against Deebo. And, oh, we missed so hard, and he's going to have room to run. Lewisine, good tackle, cleaned up, 15-yard gain. It might have been the fact that we didn't get our play switched out quick enough, but, yeah, not a huge fan of that. Back with the same formation, might be another run, and it is going to be another run as Harrison's going to get out there and get a grab of his foot for no gain. The rookie Price, maybe a guy that they're going to look to run with a lot this season, not 100% sure what the plan is there, because Mitchell's still there. I thought he either traded him or he was trying to trade him, so see how that goes, you know, as the season goes on. As he's going to run the ball again, and we're going to miss. Oh, it's Deebo running the ball, actually, getting a gain of 13. Yeah, that's the number. Stopping the run. Not a strong suit for us so far. Of course, does have Trent Williams as well, so it's important to mention that. He's obviously a very good player. Wide open Kittle. Misses the throw with Trey Lance, QB1. I don't know how he's going to deal with pressure, so we're going to bring some. Dantzler going against Deebo is probably not a good look, though, as we're pretty good coverage, and that's really good coverage by Dantzler, to be honest. Throws slightly out of reach again, but realistically, that could be on him, and if it is, it's kind of BS, because that throw is a little too good. I know Trey Lance has got a decent deep ball, but my man's threw that literally perfectly. Go with Kendricks. He's got Lurker, of course. Chance to get off the field here. Over the middle. Not really going to have much of a chance. And Dantzler pursues poorly, and that's going to be not a touchdown because he sold. Dantzler's all over that, and he's pursuing the ball as if he's got a chance at a pick. Why is he not preventing more yardage gain? This is, of course, a run. And good cutback. We have Bolden, by the way, because Bubba Bolden was a free agent. And I was like, I need a long-term safety probably because Harrison Smith, how good is he going to be next year? I don't know. So definitely glad to have a young, fast player for the future potentially. Depends if we can even pay him. Lewisine, and I can't get off to him. Good job, Kendricks. Kind of got beat on that A button press thing, but overall stopped him, I suppose. Lewisine. Oh, that's a really good play to the outside. I was too busy kind of messaging him. How do we not make that tackle? Deebo breaking free to the four. Kind of want a run commit, but even if it is a run, you know, do we really need to commit? Probably, actually. All over with Scene, and there's nobody out there because think said Za'Darius getting locked up one-on-one with Ayuk. This is why we need preseason, because I'm not like super comfortable with a 3-4, and we're seeing Za'Darius dropping back a lot. I don't know if that's just like me being dumb with playmate, you know, formations and calls, but I feel like that's just the way the team goes, no? Play action play here is not bad. Mon, the starter for this week. And that is going to be pick first play. Good read. Really bad read by me there, to be fair. Guy is absolutely all over that. It's just a bad play. Get our pass rushers actually doing a pass rush. And that's a read option. Scene? Do you mind Scene? Nice hit to the knees on Trey Lance. Does Scene really mind? Like, if you get beat by the play, fair enough. But you weren't beat by the play because you were sitting there. Lewisine didn't go to the running back or the quarterback. He just sat around. I'm not really sure what that was about, but good play, I guess. That's so dumb. My guy's just sitting there. Pitch to the right, and wow, Danielle Hunter there for a loss of 6, almost 7. That's pretty good coverage, though, and once again, the pass rush, Za'Darius all over it this time. Back him off a little bit. Scene, maybe not that far back, but sure. We'll take a run every day of the week, because, I mean, you're pretty much guaranteed a field goal from 50 yards out anyways. Definitely want to do a little bit better on offense, but once again, Mondas the starter. May not get much more time to play as it's nearing the second quarter. Jefferson looks good pre-snap, but... And there he goes. Mond with a perfect throw. Fred Warner taking him down from behind. Gain of 25 on the play, pretty much. Looking for something on that right side. There goes Jefferson again. Holds on. Gains 7. Inside zone with Dalvin. There is like a chance. Oh, we have confusion with the play art or something. There goes Dalvin. Oh, what a move. Don't fumble. I hate that. If I fumble this year in a big situation because I don't instantly hold the right bumper or X button, I'm going to be pissed. I'm going to be sad. I actually like this play even though we'll still run it. Screw it. Yeah, look, he hesitated. There's that user element. Ah, we didn't get that many yards because we sold on the sideline. I tried a cut move last second. But there's that user element. You know, he's trying to cover the cutback potentially or the counter dive, whatever it is. Because he brings everyone over to that side thinking, oh, that's settled. But without the linebacker there, it's just, you know, across the board, everyone's perfectly blocked up. And we end up getting 9. This play action play is pretty good. But Thielen on the main route of this? I don't know. Thielen? Nice catch, Thielen. I know Thielen's a little slower, but Ward covering perfectly man up like that, that's... I don't know if I like that, but hey, it worked out. We ended up getting the first, and everyone's happy. First and goal from the 7, except for him, who we thought probably had a pick, maybe. And I'm just forced to throw it down. Once again, Ward playing literally perfect coverage. Glad that it appears that speed is the only thing that matters again. Nice. Love that route running doesn't really matter that much. One of my favorite things about Madden. Screw route running. Speed. And there goes Jefferson, finishing the drive that he pretty much started with about 40 yards on the drive. Coming back with a nice, you know, comeback drive after throwing that pick. Nice dot. Nick Bosa just getting there, but a little too late. Works out. Mond under a bit of pressure all, you know, game so far. Delivering a pretty good set of throws. Manned up Dantzler against Debo again. Slot receiver. We definitely need to go by speed after this. Keep saying it, I just don't do it. I sold on the hit stick. Oh, they switched me to the wrong guy. I wanted Neal. Our interior does suck. Not really anyone to trade for, though. He can take the deeper play because Asamoah was there. Good block. Asamoah's got speed, and he'll score. Love to see him get a camp breakout or camp standout, whatever the hell it's called, but had to let the deeper throw go because, once again, you're not going to hit every throw in this league or in this Madden in general. Especially with lower overall rated players. So, you know, if I got to take the shot on where he's going to throw it, I'm going to guess low because it's just too hard to throw deep. So I'm just going to let maybe gravity do the work for that anyways. Not bad, though. Booth actually, like, going against somebody of his caliber. And under pressure, he's actually going to get it to Debo still. That's absolutely absurd, dude. And he's under pressure. We brought the blitz, and Daniil, of course, in general, getting there. We're probably going to... This is why we wanted to play preseason. Like, we normally never play preseason in this league, but, you know, we're probably going to need to raise those pass block sliders by a bit. But Daniil Hunter's feasting. Zadarius not looking terrible either. He's just a bit slower, so he's not able to actually finish the play much. Go with Kendricks, even though he probably doesn't need a user. The middle looking pretty good, and he's going to throw it away. Smart call. Debatably grounding, but he also threw it so far. Backing up. Debo kind of winning his route. We do have a safety there, though. Lewis seen all over there. On the scene. Good D. Good swat. Try to swat it back into play for one of our guys to catch it, but couldn't do it. We do have a bunch of... I need to learn the routes on Jefferson, but we do have a bunch of those, like, route options. There's a good throw. Irv Smith. Good job by him to not use her, because... In previous Maddens, I've been like, ah, you little P-word that ends with a Y. But this Madden, you know, you might see a little bit out of that from me, too. So what can I tell you? One-on-one, though, Jeff. Nah, we're still going to run it. So surprised that all these guys are still in, though. Would have thought our backups would have come in by now. Good move by Dalvin. Gains like a yard or two. Oh, nice move. Dalvin to the 15. Dalvin's going to be a lot of fun. We never have an established running back early on. And even last year, we had a running back that didn't really have any abilities. So like the first year sometime that we've actually had like a decent running back out the gate, and he's more than decent, obviously, so don't yell at me. Wheel drag. Could be looking for Davidson here. It's a tall boy. He's a tall boy. Good catch. Gains 5. Not bad. And that's a touchdown. Perfect throw to Thielen. Not bad. Mond controlling the offense pretty well. Gotta be honest. This is a franchise that's realistic-ish. At least the gameplay will be for the most part. Oh, look at Phillips. The big man. Goddamn. Look at him go. Usering with Phillips, dude. I usered with freaking Phillips. He's going to run the ball again. And good try by Debo. Fumble! I think we have it. Once again, I hate... Oh, achievement. User... I don't know. It said something about tendencies or something like that. I don't know. Well, actually, I'm going to user this. I'm going to throw this. And there goes Thielen. Down to the 5. Still have our starters in, though. I'm not really sure what's going on here, but... Pulling off that user with Cook. Cook might have a wide open run. There he goes. Touchdown, Cook. What a game so far. We looked really bad out the gate, similar to the first game. And then we've turned it around completely, looking really strong. And this kick might be missed, especially with him blocking it. Oh, what a block. Kirk, you better get this. Good block, good block. I wonder if he blocked it just blocking it, or if because my accuracy was off, they were like, the person's not going to be too mad about an RNG type of thing with a block. So, you know, because, like, I was probably going to miss that. So I wonder if that's... Because 90% of the time when I get blocked, it's because I missed, you know? So Kendrick's in man against the running back. And he probably had Kittle more open, but a first down's a first down. Didn't go out of bounds, though, which could be not great for him. Oh, that is a wide open player. Good D. Coming with some crazy blitzes here. Let's get Booth actually playing coverage, though. The safety's on that. Lewisine should have been picked. Glad it wasn't called PI, but I could see if they would have called it, you know. Definitely seemed a little bit of like, some contact there. I'm probably going to end up having to do that a lot. I'm going to leave the inside open quite a bit, but the safety's going to have to play to the outside a lot for us, I think. Is that Debo with... Oh, that's good D. The safety, or whoever it was, the blitz. I'll call a timeout. Why not? And it's a good kick. 13-27. It's not a good kick. It was missed. No, oh, he's like, wait a minute. Dalvin Cook on the run. See what we got. Try to fake him out a little bit by cutting late just to see if maybe he would like wait for it, and then I would just run straight down, but it is what it is. Ty Chandler on the inside handoff, I think, is looking okay pre-snap. Oh, wow. Good fight, but he regathers. I'm not really even sure the point of me fighting for it then. It's pretty stupid. There you go. Rager. Nice move. Rager's got room. Oh! Jalen Rager. 78 yards. I feel bad about celebrating, but like I said, I mean, it's probably too late for, you know, if he's watching the video or something like that. But anyone that plays me, if you destroy me, you know, 50-0, you make a crazy play, you can celebrate whenever the hell you want. Jimmy Garoppolo coming out here. Might have the wrong subs out. No, I don't. That was a little bit of a late read. I missed hard. It is cool to see, like, even though those are probably animations, it's cool to see that there's animations like that where it's like, it doesn't feel animation heavy, even though it kind of is. He's so open over there. Oh, nice move. Bynum, good tackle. We really should replace Bynum as well. I don't know what his contract's like. Bolden going against the running back. Oh, we're torched. Good recovery by us, but in fairness... Oh, that was something. Want him. Really don't want him, to be honest. Oh, huge hit. Awesome. Oh, great tackle. Come with another blitz. Pass rusher going against whoever the hell that is. Running back, it seems. Damn, that's a good lead. I can't believe, like, well, I mean, I tried to run right away, but I got bumped by my own guy. He's going for those checkdowns hard. It's very hard to cover, though, and I mean, honestly don't know how teams in real life do it. To be honest, they kind of don't, if we're going to be, like, fully truthful. And that's good. Oh, the DT. He ain't going to have the speed. Pitch it. No. That's not a bad throw. Like, I don't care that he picked that. I was testing really the throw there more than anything. Oh, nice tackle by O'Neal. Holy. That's testing the throw more than anything. And he actually hit it. It was on the money. It's just he was there with the coverage. Good user. Lynch getting a pretty good push. Good D. Is that Bynum? Damn. Run to the left. Look at Ty. Look at Ty Chandler turn it into a 9-yard gain almost. With that tight end play. Everyone knows what this is, though. So we're going to uncut Osborne and see what we're looking at. That's impossible. It's not Tyree Jackson's fault, so not going to blame him on that one. There he goes. He was turning around too late with a slower player, and I was like, I'm taking that dot every day of the week. Bit of pressure there, so if he would have had a better guy with change direction, I might not have had a chance to react to it. So, once again, I can't really tell who the best quarterback is, but it just seems like it doesn't matter who you got. Oh, that's a bad play. Oh, they're not going to give him that. That's a weird play by us. Ty Chandler turning into a decent gainer. Play action. We have Osborne cutting a right. Oh, that's a free rusher. Oh, there you go. That's a play the athleticism guys can do. What a move. Tyree Jackson. I don't know who they're all good. All the quarterbacks are good. Kirk Cousins is useless. Oh, is he going to lift him? Bruh. That's a play and a half. That's a preseason highlight if I've ever seen one. Beautiful play. I'm going to use your bold, and I'm going to try to get a press on Ray McCloud. And pressure again. That's going to be a slider that does need to go up, though, I'd say. Although I can't tell if he's dropping back too far or not. Third and 21. I mean, that's a pretty good throw. Sullivan's there, though, and knocked down by Bynum. Man, it's really tough. Do you choose the slightly faster, younger Mond, or do you choose the stronger, taller Tyree Jackson? I don't know. Never mind. And he's not going to get there. Nice cutback attempt. If it wasn't for his user, though, that was following through, probably wouldn't have been a big play. Another play action play. And there goes Osborne again. I don't know if it was again or not, but... Oh, that's a good play by him. Don't fumble. I really like Osborne. He looks cool, and he kind of looks like freaking... What's his name? Devontae Adams, and he's kind of cool and fun, but... Oh, that's a good play by him. Don't fumble. He's just too old, dude. He's 25, and he's only 89 speed. You gotta remember, in real life, you can't compare real life to Madden, because in real life, a 29-year-old can come out of nowhere and dominate, but in game, that ain't gonna happen. It just won't. Ty... Nice truck, but he fumbles. Damn it, dude. These fumble. Oh, my Lord, he's dying. These fumbles are crazy, man. And he's in trouble off the edge. Whoever the hell that is. I should probably learn our players, even though I probably won't have to because these are all backups anyways. Is it actually Wanham? It's either Wanham or Robinson. One of the damn two. And that's pretty good coverage by Perry. And dropped. Well, not dropped, but through his hands, if you will. Ty Chandler to the outside. Ty Chandler showing off a bit of speed. Oh, that's a huge hit by Hufanga. Read option probably not going to work because there's like 45 players off that edge, but I'm going to keep it anyways. Run! What a move! Ah, he played so scared there. Come on. Dive at me, baby. Oh, I think he accidentally pump faked, but it saved him. Bolden, who's Bolden covering? Are we on the running back? Oh, he does actually have him. That throw's pretty good. No, it's slightly over. Evans. Nice pick. Third and 20. Why not throw the ball up? I think he brings the guy on the wrong side every time, though. Nice stiff arm. Ty Chandler is good, though. If he was younger, nothing, because we have our guy. We have Dalvin Cook. That's the guy's name. Can't switch the side. Whatever. Good fight. First down on the last play. Not a bad little preseason game. He played pretty well. There was some moments he probably would like to have back. So would I, especially that first throw at Kellen Mond. I don't know if it was the first throw, but threw a pick pretty early. The Tyree Jackson one, I don't want that back at all. That was a great throw. Bad decision. Just wanted to see if he could hit that throw. I think it was like second down anyways. I don't really care too much. Really about testing scenarios, testing the limits of our players and team. And really, the quarterbacks look great. I mean, they actually look really great. We actually have a problem of too much talent at quarterback, whereas normally it's like, well, Kirk's the best you can get. But Kellen Mond killed it. Tyree was decent. Obviously, Kirk didn't really play much, but he had that one really long play to Rager, who did really well in that play. Receivers, you know, just a bunch of guys getting catches. Thielen looked pretty good. Jefferson looked insane, like guardable. You know, had to bring multiple at times. The pass rush was crazy good. I mean, really, really good preseason game. If we don't have a bad game in preseason week three, I mean, this will be one of those like, wow, this team could go places, you know? We also got an achievement, win a head-to-head match online league. Okay, should have had that last game, but, opponent dashboard. I mean, they lied, just the game didn't count. It probably was just the EA servers because they're just so bad. But, of course, that is going to be it for episode one of our Minnesota Vikings Online User Franchise. Week one against the Packers is next as our opponent cannot play for game three of preseason, which really does kind of suck because it was a close battle between Mond and Tyree Jackson for QB1, in my opinion. So, I don't know. And once again, I'm sorry. I there might be some Vikings fans that might not even be able to watch because we're not using Kirk. Maybe before week one of real life Vikings, maybe they would, but now they're like, Captain Kirk's our boy, but he's just too old. Now, if we struggle a ton with these two quarterbacks, of course, the quarterback's accuracy and the O-line slider is going to be changing, so, it could be impossible to use these guys. We will go to Kirk, but as far as developing him goes, you just can't. He's too old and his dev is too bad, so bear with me while we try to find a franchise quarterback that actually can last like 5 seasons. Anyways, though, hopefully you guys did enjoy this one. If you did, maybe leave a like, subscribe if you're new. If you're not new, really appreciate your continued support. If you're, once again, not new, you probably have seen, some iteration of the online franchise. This is going to be a bit of a different year, though, for us, as it's the first time on Next Gen, and you guys know I'm a little sussy on Next Gen. And maybe follow me on Twitter, JohnPierre, second channel, Pierre Plays for non-Madden stuff. Or just for non-video stuff, because I've been lacking over there. I'm not going to make a promise. At some point, I'll tell you what, at 100%, I'm going to start uploading there soon. And we'll be rolling. But when, I don't know. And of course, 500 likes for episode 2, aka week 1, tomorrow for this franchise. So that's about it. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys come back for next video. But until next video, see ya!